Everyone, welcome to Unacademy. This is Riya Agarwal, and today we are going to see some more problems on quantitative reasoning for CAT. Because as you know, practice is the key to master logical reasoning section for CAT. Also, you can download the Unacademy learning app from App Store or Play Store and follow me there to find more of my courses. Apart from that, you can rate, review and share the video with your friends. Please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. So let us continue with our course on logical reasoning, which was based on quantitative reasoning. And today we are going to see some more problem sets. Here is a little about me section. I am an electronics and communication engineer and I have scored 98.29 percentile in DI and LR section of CAT. What is quantitative reasoning? It is the intersection of disciplinary context, critical thinking and mathematics. So we'll see what it is. The question will be given in some real world scenario. You will have to critically think and convert it to basic mathematics and then solve it. This is all about quantitative reasoning. The key skills involved to solve this kind of questions will be, number one, you need to understand by looking at the question what is the quantitative logic to be used in the question. Number two, you need to know how to use the clues in some proper order. Number three, you need to have the understanding of basic mathematical concepts like percentage, averages, ratios, multiplications, etc. Number four, you need to create symbolic representations of some clues if they can't be used at the given point of time so that you can later bring it together to solve the question. Number five, the ability to infer information from indirect clues, which means sometimes the clues will be given in indirect method where you can't directly get some information from the clue but you can get it indirectly. So you should know what the clue is trying to convey. We'll move on to the problem. Question number one. Study the following information and answer the following questions. It is very easy to remember the ID number of my ATM card, which is 9-digit number, and every digit is distinct. If I tell you some of the clues, then you will be able to remember my ATM card ID number. Let us say the number is PQRSTUVWX, and the digits corresponding to it are 1 to 9, though not respectively. So each of these letters represent one of the digits from 1 to 9. And every digit is distinct. The ID is divisible by 9. If you delete the digits in the unit's place, which means if you delete this last digit, the remaining 8 digits number will be divisible by 8. Similarly, if you delete the second last digit as well, then this remaining 7 digits number will be divisible by 7, and the process goes on. Okay. So as you can see, this question says that it is easy to remember, but it's very difficult to find out this ID because there are many possibilities. These digits 1 to 9 can be used in various ways to form this ID, and we need to go through various processes, and you need to know all the divisibility rules to solve this question. Like for example, a number is divisible by 2 only if the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. In this case, 0 is not in our range. So, 2, 4, 6 or 8. For a number to be divisible by 3, the sum of the digits should be divisible by 3. For a number to be divisible by 4, the last two digits should be divisible by 4. Similarly, for a number to be divisible by 5, the last digit should be either 0 or 5. So in this case, it should be 5. So this is one fixed information which tells me for the 5-digit number, which means PQRST, it is sure that T should be 5. Only then this question will be solved, because this 5-digit number should be divisible by 5. And to be divisible by 5, the last digit, that is T, should be either 0 or 5. But in this case, 0 is not in our solution range. So the only option that remains for T is to be 5. Okay. Next, for a number to be divisible by 6, it should be divisible both by 2 and 3. Next, for a number to be divisible by 7, we need to cross off the last digit, double it and subtract. And then repeat it if we want. And if the new number that is divisible by 7, only then the original number will be divisible by 7, which is a long rule. Next, for a number to be divisible by 8, if the last two digits are divisible by 8, only then the number will be divisible by 8. Similarly, for 9, if the sum of the digits are divisible by 9, only then the number will be divisible by 9. Okay, so this also can be checked since the digits are 1 to 9 and if we add all of them, it will give us 45. So sum of digit will, in any order placed the digits, it will be 45, which is divisible by 9. 45 by 9 is 5. So also I have checked this, but I don't have any hint for this. To solve this question, I have to go through all these divisibility rules and use it one by one to get the solution. So it will be a very lengthy solution and you won't know whether at the end you will get the correct answer or not, and you will be wasting a lot of time. So the motive behind getting this question today is not to show you how to solve the question and get the answer. It is to show you that in this exam it is important that you mark the correct option rather than you be able to solve the question. So I'll first tell you a little about how we will go through the steps so that we can reach the solution, but then I'll tell you the shortcut method through which we can solve the question in only a minute's time and not do all this calculation and get the all the options correct. So let us see. If we start with this, deduction one will be that since this number has to be divisible by respective digits, like if it is a two digit number, that is PQ, it has to be divisible by 2. So this digit Q should be an even number for it to be divisible by 2. Similarly, all these positions Q, S, U and W should be even numbers, whereas the other remaining 5 digits should be odd numbers. In some order, we don't know the order yet. We know nothing about the order. Now, this I have already told you, since PQRST is divisible by 5, T must be equal to 5. So the number is PQRS5UVWX. Okay. Deduction 3, PQR is divisible by 3. Because this is the first 3 digits, it has to be divisible by 3. And PQRSTU should be divisible by 6, because this is the first 6 digits. Hence, this STU must also be divisible by 2 and 3. And how do we check divisibility for 3? S plus T plus U should be equal to, is equal to S plus 5 plus U, since T is equal to 5. And so this must be divisible by 3. Also we know that S and U are even numbers. So now, and there are only 4 even numbers that can be, that is 2, 4, 6 and 8. So I have used all some trial and error methods and found out that STU can either be 258 or it can be 654. So this goes on and on and on. And it's not sure if you can end up and find all the questions. Number 2 is maybe you don't know the divisibility rule for all of this. So how do you solve this? There's just one thing you should be knowing even to use the shortcut method, that is this deduction, that T must be equal to 5. Now I go to the questions and use the elimination method to solve the question, and you see how we can do it in just a minute's time. So here, what is the sum of the digits of the ID number of my ATM card? So I know already that since all the digits will be from 1 to 9 range and they are distinct, no digit is repeated. So I know the sum of digits from 1 to 9 is 45. So I can just mark this question even if I can't solve the remaining questions, even if I have not read, even if I have not gone through all this, I can just mark this if I have just read the question, because I know that the number has to be from 1 to 9 and the sum will be 45. Okay, now how do we solve this? We don't know what does the letter R represent, since we have not come across the ATM ID yet. Also we can't solve this for now, but if you see in question 4 and 5, they have given the IDs in the option, and since there is no none of these option, maybe we can figure out the ID from this options. So let us check question 4. What are the first 5 digits of the ID number of my ATM card? Okay, so I know nothing about the first 5 digits, but all I know is that from the first 5 digits, the 5th digit has to be 5. And if I check the option, I find out that there is just one option which satisfies this condition. So option A is the correct answer. Next, what are the last 5 digits of the ID number of my ATM card? So again, I know since we are talking about the last 5 digits, the first digit, that is T, should be equal to 5. And if I check the options, there is just one option A which satisfies the condition. Thus, I can say I have the ID now which is equal to 381647 29. So I have the complete ID here just by solving these two questions. Now I can solve these two questions as well. What is the number represented by letter R? So these are the first five digits, P, Q, R. So the third digit, that is 1. So answer is C. Question 3. The number 2 represents which letter? The number 2 is here, second last number. So it will represent the digit V. No, sorry. It will represent the digit W. So option B. Therefore, I have solved all these questions without going through the pain of using the divisibility rule, which was my intention. My intention was to get all these questions correct and in minimum time as possible. That is what I have done. But still, if you want the solution of this in the complex manner, you can post it in the comment and I will let you know. Thank you very much. If you like and understand my approach, please rate, review and share the video. All the very best for your endeavor.